Today we're gonna make a black and white mango Negroni. So if you love Negronis, I think you're gonna love this. If you love coffee, you're definitely gonna love this. It's really easy to make, it looks amazing, it tastes amazing. So without further ado, let's make the drink. So before we start making the drink, I should talk about a white Negroni and what this is. So essentially a white Negroni is a riff on a classic Negroni. Classic Negroni having a gin base, Campari and sweet vermouth. The white Negroni makes this not completely clear, which I'll talk about in a second, but brings a slightly different flavor profile using gin, Sousa in place of Campari, and then a drier style vermouth or aromatized wine rather than your sweet vermouth. So it's a really simple riff. We often change the formula slightly to have a little bit more of the gin in there to bring that kind of spirit forward flavor through. And what we're gonna do today is add the missing piece to this drink and also make it more white, which I think is really nice when it comes to the aesthetic of the drink. So I do really like the original white Negroni, but as I said before, it's not completely clear. And something you can do to kind of clean up the flavor a little bit, make it a little bit less herbal, which the Sousa has loads of that kind of herbal flavor in a gentian-based liqueur, is switch out the Sousa, switch in Luxardo bitter, which is a bit of a kind of cleaner bitterness, much less herbal, very slightly lighter. And I just think really makes the drink a little bit more clear in terms of flavor, but also how it looks. So this is a much lighter color than Sousa, and this is gonna be the first switch we make. And then to finish off the drink, to add the kind of missing piece, which is the flavor of coffee, which I think works really nicely, we're gonna be adding my secret weapon, which is gonna be the single origin coffee liqueur from Algebra. So in the past, I've made versions of the black and white coffee Negroni before, the black part being the black coffee on top of the drink, the white part being the white Negroni base. And it's a great drink, but I think I've really taking it to the next level using the Algebra coffee liqueur. And the reason for that is before I'd used filter coffee, which was fine and it worked really nicely, but the coffee flavor wasn't quite dominant enough. The color distinction between the two wasn't as clear, but this version, it's got way more coffee flavor, way more coffee kind of clarity as well. So you really taste the coffee itself. And then the base is much cleaner, much lighter, and I think it works really well. So the Algebra single origin coffee liqueur is the key to this. As it says, it's a single origin. You've got complete traceability of the coffee. This is an Ethiopian natural process coffee roasted by Ozone Coffee Roasters. They're based in London. They do an amazing job. One of the really nice things about this particular coffee liqueur is it's got a really low sugar content of just 71 grams of sugar per liter, which is much lower than you often find in coffee liqueurs. This has two really kind of high benefits. First of all, you can taste the coffee. The coffee in there is really good. You want to taste it, which is a really good thing. But second of all, you get that really nice definition between the layers because the sugar content is lower than the base beneath it. So with kind of commercial coffee liqueurs, you get a much higher sugar content. It just sinks into the white Negroni. You end up with like a murky brown Negroni, which isn't what we're looking for. We want black and white, really clear layers, really clear kind of flavor distinction. And that's exactly what this gives. So this has a flavor profile of mango, cola, and a kind of floral characteristic as well. Really defining flavor profiles you get in an Ethiopian coffee. Some really nice tropical fruit in there. And we're gonna build our white Negroni base around the flavor of the coffee liqueur. So they're gonna really complement each other nicely. So big thanks to Algebra for creating this amazing single origin coffee liqueur. Thanks for sponsoring this video. And you can check out the website in the description below if you wanna pick this up for yourselves, which I recommend doing. Now we're gonna make our black and white mango Negroni. So the first ingredient we're gonna add is our mango gin. And this is a really versatile ingredient, really easy to make. This ties in really nicely with the mango flavors in the coffee that you find. And all you do is combine one part of dried mango with 10 parts of gin. Leave this in a sealed jar for around about 5 days, and it really pulls all that mango flavor into the gin. For this drink, I've chosen a really floral gin because we want to tie into the floral notes of the coffee liqueur. I've gone with Roku from Japan. Really kind of delicate, floral, botanical gin. Really delicious on its own. But when you combine it with a mango, it just rounds everything out, brings that kind of tropical fruit flavor, and it's the perfect base for our drink. So keep tasting this. Around about 5 days later, you get loads of mango flavor in the gin. Pass it through a sieve into a bowl, and you're left with this amazing mango gin, which we're gonna add 40 mils of. So a classic Negroni would be equal parts, but a white Negroni tends to lean more heavily into the kind of spirit base, which is what we're doing here. So 40 mils of this, 20 mils of our Luxardo bitter for our kind of bittersweet characteristic, which is very delicious. And then we're gonna go in with 20 mils of Cocky Americano, which is a drier style aromatized wine. We're just gonna stir this down for around about 10 to 15 seconds because we wanna bring a little bit of dilution, but not too much because we're gonna serve it over ice and just to really chill it down. And then we're gonna strain this over a clear ice block. And then to finish the drink, we're gonna add our kind of black layer to the drink, which is gonna be 20 mils of that single origin coffee liqueur from Algebra. So this is gonna float perfectly on top of the drink, and it should do on camera as well. And this is just gonna bring that really nice coffee flavor in the first few sips of the drink, which will develop as you enjoy the drink. It did work. Gonna garnish with a nice slice of mango as a little snack. And there we have the black and white mango Negroni. So there we have it. What I think is a really cool looking drink. I've had this drink before. I know how it tastes. Tastes really good. The first sip's really full of that coffee flavor. A little bit of the kind of cola flavor coming through. Just a hint of the white Negroni underneath, which is kind of teasing you for what's gonna come later. And then as you work your way through the drink, you get more of that mango, more of the bittersweet notes coming through as well. And it just really develops. So I don't recommend stirring this. I think having that layered experience is really nice. Loads of coffee, which then settles as you drink through the drink. Mango, it's really, really well balanced, really nice and cold. And I strongly recommend you give this a try. So big thanks again to this video's sponsor, which is Algebra. As I said, check out in the description below. They do three amazing products, an extra dry coffee liqueur, a decaf coffee liqueur, and this single origin coffee liqueur. I'll link more videos for you to watch here and here, which I hope you enjoy. And if you've enjoyed this, you can subscribe to the channel by clicking just here. So I'm gonna go back to this, keep enjoying it as it changes, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.